Hey everyone, Andrew here, and it's time for another top five. This one was an idea that I came up with pretty early on in the year, maybe even last year, that I've been trying to figure out how to do it and what ones to talk about and how to make this list work. Because it's a chance for me to talk about one of my favorite things, but also the thing that makes liking that very difficult. And the thing that I'm going to be talking about is anime. Because I'm a big anime fan, big manga fan, I enjoy the medium, I really like it. But one of the things that I've been having a problem with the medium in general is that the quality tends to not last. And that they tend to get a little too confusing or a little too complex or too repetitive or whatever and start to fall apart. And to be fair, I have this problem with a lot of mediums. You can get that with books, I can get that with manga. The one that I come close to associating that with is comics, where it's just they go on for so long and have so much happen and get so confusing and so convoluted that at a certain point you're just like, I'm done. Then you push them away and you don't want to keep up with it. Or it gets to be a lot. And that's sort of one of the things that can happen with anime is that, like, at a certain point, it starts to fall apart. But I always try to stick with anime until the very end. There is an ending for them. Because, to me, an ending is the make or break thing. It's the thing that can save a bad story, it's the thing that can ruin a great story. And anime, unfortunately, tends to have a bit of a problem with how they end their animes. Most animes have either a meh kind of ending or leaning towards bad. And I figured out that part of the problem is a lot of them go for cliche endings. And they have a lot of consistency in some of that. And I figured I would talk about that. And I'm not gonna say I'm an expert in this in any way. I've not watched every anime, I don't know everything about all of them. But these are the ones, the cliches that I've been coming across the most and that have the most negative effects or can have the most negative problems. And like with some of these, I will explain like, oh, well, there's good versions of this and there are bad versions of this. Most of these may not even be the worst finale of anime that I've ever seen, with a couple exceptions, but I will point those ones specifically out. Yeah, so today I will be talking about the top 5 worst cliche anime endings. And spoiler warning, and I'm gonna just go ahead and include here every single film that I'm gonna be talking about, because there's gonna be a couple. And yeah, so if you don't want to be spoiled for any of these animes, just no, probably don't watch this. So, the most common ending you're gonna find to any anime is quite simply the status quo ending, or the journey never ends. This is an ending that you tend to get a lot, especially with shows that are wanting to do more, or wanting to do a spin-off, or wanting to continue in some way, shape, or form. It's just literally the main characters are basically about to the exact same stat that they were at the beginning of the season. Or the beginning of the show, and just continue on their merry way. This isn't necessarily a negative thing. There's a lot of great shows that do this. You got Dragonball Z also kind of did this. The Slayer series, which I truly love, and each of them end that way, but that's because they know at some point they're going to get to do another spin-off series that continues this adventure. And, so it's not necessarily always a bad thing, but there are times when that is not a good way to end that series, especially if that series isn't short. For me, the worst ones of these are the ones that are ridiculously long to start, and then they just keep going. Basically, the show that had like hundreds of episodes, had multiple seasons, and then they're like, okay, we're gonna end here. We're gonna do this as the final season. And instead of giving us a finale, they just go, well, we beat that boss. On to the next adventure! And the best example of how this can be done badly for me is Fairy Tail. Now, Fairy Tail is a really good long-running series with some really interesting characters and interesting ideas. But when you got to the point of the final arc, it was starting to dip a lot. Fairy Tail was already kind of on a downward slope, and especially got bad once I realized that they started doing fake deaths, where characters would be in situations where they could not possibly survive, and then they managed to survive. It's like, and they would fake you out and do fake outs with these deaths. Like, oh no, this person's dead. And then, like, less than an episode or two later, nope, they're alive, they're fine. Like, and they did this like 7 or 8 times. And by the end of the anime, like, they'd tried to kill off like half the cast, and yet everyone was still alive, even the main bad guy and his ghost girlfriend, who've been dead for years, are both kind of alive. So it's like, okay, but that would have been fine, except the way the series ends, it ends with the main guy, Natsu, and the main girl, Lucy, going out and starting on an adventure to do go do something for fairy tales. Like, we're going on our next adventure. And I'm like, wait, really? You're just gonna. They just keep going. We're not gonna, deal with the fact that all of these people are this and that and the other. Nothing has changed. You're not gonna acknowledge the fact that you two have had emotional moments and you shouldn't actually have realized by now that you both like each other in a more than a friend kind of way. No, you're just gonna continue on like nothing happened. So we're back to the status quo. Literally, this series kind of ends at the exact same point that it started. It's still these three main characters going off on adventures, but nothing that has happened for the entirety of the series matters. It didn't change them at all. They're the same characters, the same arc, same story. They're doing the same stuff. And again, that's not a bad ending overall. It's just super frustrating when you've watched 300 plus episodes of a show and they just choose to end with a shrug that everything's going back to normal. It also has this air of desperation. Like, they are begging for you to, or the network, or whoever, to give them a spin-off, or another show, or another season. And again, if it's not, if it, the story hasn't come to an end, okay. Fairy Tales came to an end. That felt like the ending. That got to the point where it got to the epicness level where it felt like a be-all, end-all kind of ending. And then you begged for more episodes, a chance to do more. Like, no. And anime's not the only one that does this. TV shows do this too. One that I really liked was called Into the Badlands on AMC over here in America. And they had 4 seasons or five. And they got to the end and they knew this was going to be the final season. And it ended in a way that was supposed to be like everything's resolved, but nope. Main character, you're alive and we need you to fight this new mystic force that may be coming. And you're like, okay, and then it fades to black. And you're like, wait, you want more? Really? It's just, to me, because it's so desperately screaming to for more money. It's not a we want to continue these characters' adventure. This is our money maker. I want to make more money. So let us do a spin-off show about more with these characters more. I don't want that. I don't want shows to go on forever. Shows that go on forever fall apart and start to become unwatchable. I'm having that with Grey's Anatomy right now, where I've watched Grey's Anatomy since from the beginning, and it's 16 plus seasons in, and it's trying to make you care about couples, and you're like, I don't give a dang about any of these couples. You're just gonna break them up at some point. You destroyed every single couple you've ever created for this show. Why should I give a damn about any of the couples? So you can't get invested in anything. Anime's not the only one that does this, but anime does this a lot. And with Fairy Tail specifically, it pissed me off because everything that came up to that point stopped mattering. Like, okay, the rest of the show is pretty good though, right? I'm like, yeah, but I have no desire to ever read it again because it's not done. And I don't want to know anymore and I don't want to continue it. I'm done. I'm sick of this. I'm out. It's like basically getting me to tap out at the freaking finale in case they do, even if they do a spin-off show. No, never. I'm not watching any more Fairy Tail ever again. Done. Like, this to me is a non-finale. This is a begging to be able to make more. And again, if the show is great throughout and it isn't like got its time, Yes, I would like more. If you did well, but I'm also the kind of person like, I want stories to eventually end. And this is a non-ending. Moving on, number four. So the status quo ending is predominant and can have a bit of that, money grabbing type of thing. The one thing that's worse for a status quo ending is a ending that is just basically they had kids. Now, this is not necessarily a bad thing. There can be good versions of this. Dragon Ball Z both had a kind of ending where it's like, oh yeah, we had a kid. And we went off and trained them to go be their own adventurers. That can kind of work. But there are times where it just really does not work and actually kind of hurts it. Like, an example of a good and bad version, because it's a little bit of both, would be Digimon Season 2. So, Digimon Season 2 ended with all of the main characters having destroyed the barrier between human world and Digi world, so all of the humans got to live with their Digimon. And then it cuts to them all as adults, and they all have kids, and all of the kids are, have their own Digimon and is moving forward to the next generation. That's kind of sweet and romantic. Except, none of the adult versions of these kids have spouses except for two who are together. So all of them have kids, but we only know of one couple. Also, all of the kids, with the exception of the two by this couple, are identical down to like the clothing and hairstyle of their older versions. They are mirror images. They all look like clones. And so I'm watching that going, did they all clone themselves to have children? Why would you do that? Also, you just destroyed every single other couple in the show because you just flat out told us none of these other couples get together. So, yay for the two side couple that I knew would be together no matter what, and every other couple's just like, eh. No, they're not together. But they had their own kids. And it's just like, ugh. But at least with that one, it felt like the ending. It felt like they were doing this. It didn't feel like a desperate cash grab to do a spin-off show about these kids. As opposed to certain other ones. Sometimes it's just them begging to make more. Such as Naruto's kid, Boruto. Like, that one doesn't bother me too much, but it has that air of like, oh yeah, no, we're done. We're done with Naruto. We're not gonna do any more. We're gonna push his kid forward to make more money, though. But I watched Boruto. I got a good chunk into Boruto. I liked it. I didn't think it was that bad. It wasn't as good as, Shippuden, but it was better than Naruto was at the beginning of Naruto, so. Yeah. And then you have, or Yashahime, which is the spin-off show for Inuyasha, which is about Inuyasha and Susanoo's daughters who team up and go on adventures. And I watched the first six episodes of that. It is literally just Inuyasha with worse characters. And I got sick of Inuyasha well before it ended. So I had to tap out. I was like, nope, no, I'm done. I don't want any more of this. It's the same thing all over again, and I got sick to death of that. Cause I know the author. I've read a lot of the stuff that this author does. She does the same thing in every single one of her series, where she just repeats herself over and over and over and over and over again ad nauseam until she's like 30 books in. And no, I did it for. I did it for Ramen 1.5. I did it for Inuyasha. I am not doing it for Yashahime. But the one that really annoyed me, the one that actually makes me mad and made me hate the entire series even more than I was starting to, had to be Bleach. And by the way, I'm more complaining about the manga ending for this than the anime, because the anime was smart enough not to do this chapter. So Bleach's ending was already kind of getting rough as it was. You would set up this Quincy supervillain who was almost completely unstoppable. Like, there was no. Ichigo had fought him like three times and got his butt mercilessly handed to him. He'd not even gotten a single hit in, type of thing. So there was no chance Ichigo should win. And then, all of a sudden, he does. Really easily. And he dies. And it's like, okay. And then it cuts to back on Earth, and you're like, oh, well, it's the same house that Ichigo grew up in, and everything should be fine. And then it's like, oh no, Ichigo's an adult. And he's married to Orihime, the other human that was his friend. And they're being visited by Rukia and Renji, who are also there. Oh, and upstairs, their kids run into each other. And both of the kids have the ability to do Shinigamian powers, and it's just... Ugh. So this ending sucked for a lot of reasons. Number one, well, first off, the entire arc was already in a really bad downward slope, and just having Ichigo randomly be like, nope, now I can win, did not work. The couples that got together are terrible. Like, the show was clearly pushing Ichigo and Rukia together. He barely had any relationship with Orihime. Like, they were friends, they had a couple moments, but she was always second fiddle to Rukia. And then you got Rukia and Renji getting together, and I'm like, Renji had a crush on her, but Rukia treated him like a brother. More so than her actual brother. Like, so, it just felt weird, and then you have their kids, and their kids have their power, and it feels like a desperate cry to get more of the show, and it makes sense, because the person making the show did not want the show to end. You know, he did not want this manga to end. It was making him money. He wanted to make more money. And wanted to tell these stories more. But it's also the thing of, like, you've had hundreds of episodes. You've had multiple seasons of anime. You've had multiple books. Just let the show end. Nobody cares about these kids. No, these kids are not needed. It was unnecessary. It was over the top. I know they want to do a spinoff show about these kids. And I'm like, no. No. No, mm-mm, no, that ending made me want to take Bleach to Bleach. It made me want to burn out everything in that series and forget it existed. And I know people who hate this ending more than I do. And I hate this ending. Like, I know people that this I was already, like, bottom of the barrel when it was in that final arc. I was done with Bleach years before, but I kept reading and kept watching because I was like, okay, I want to know. Oh, and I know there's people out there that love Bleach and would want to see more Bleach and wouldn't mind watching a show about those kids. Have at it. I just want nothing about the show ever told to me, ever. I don't want to see commercials about it. I don't want to be told about the story. I don't know. As far as I'm concerned, Bleach is a nightmare that I never want to experience again. So, there are some shows that have a great finale, and then they just have another episode after that that has nothing to do with anything. This is a filler episode in general. And there's a couple that you can do this. You could argue that Naruto did this before it became Shippuden, that the entire two or three seasons is kind of a filler ending between the series. And there's a couple other ones that do this, but the one that comes to mind for me most is a set of films that are connected, and that is Please Teacher and Please Twins. Now, the Please Teacher one was fine. The ending for the actual show was great, and then you had a full extra episode that was just the main couple getting together and being together, and then having their first intimate relationship, and how all the chaos that came around that. But that was at least kind of interesting and kind of worked. But then you had the Please Twins, and that ending is just... Ugh. So, Please Twins, the entire plot of Please Twins is basically these three kids move into a house, and they each have a picture of these two kids in a pool. One is a boy, one is a girl. So this guy has the picture, and both of these girls have the picture, and neither girl knows who is the one in the picture. So they all live together to try to figure it out, and both of the girls start developing an interest in the boy. And then you get to the end of how the show actually ended. Younger girl managed to find proof that she is the actual sister to this boy. And they have a big, you know, happy family celebration thing, but the older girl is like, oh, okay, well, I guess I should leave because I'm not a part of this family. I'm not your sister. And tries to leave, and the boy stops her, and he's like, I care about you, I want you to be a part of my life. Well, you know, and they decide that they're going to start dating. They then do a voiceover from the younger sister speaking, going, "Oh, hey, we eventually found out that she was also our sister. That she and the boy were in the picture, and I was asleep in the house when the picture was taken. So we're all actually siblings." Not the worst ending, kind of stupid. Like, really? Like, okay, they're all siblings, that's fine, I guess. They then do a filler episode that takes place immediately after them starting to date, but before they find out that they're brother and sister, actually. So the entire episode is all around these two lovebirds trying to get closer together and start to have a more physical relationship. Meanwhile, little sister is jealous because big brother isn't as paying as much attention to him now that he has a girlfriend. A girlfriend who is his sister. And we watch him not only make out with her, but have very close to sexual interactions with. And it's just so... ugh. And I don't... it's not the incest thing that's the problem for me. I've come across stories that are incest. It's fairly somewhat common thing in anime. And I don't even have a huge problem with it more often than not. The problem with this one is that it's two people trying to have a deep emotional relationship with physical connection that don't know their brother and sister. And so you know the second they get together, every single thing that they did as a couple is going to come back to them in horrific imagery. It's like, oh my god, I kissed my sister. Oh my god, I put my hand down my sister's. Yeah, that is going to be horrific. And that we as the audience know their brother and sister, but have to watch them do this, is just... next subject, please. So, some endings have super positive endings. Everyone's happy, everyone gets to go on with their journey. And some animes choose to do the extreme opposite. Or as I like to call them, the everybody's dead endings. And, yeah, again, much like the status quo returns endings, this isn't necessarily a bad thing. If it's a bunch of bad people kind of, you know, getting killed off or something in that nature, or most of them, you know, in a situation where there's literally no chance they should really be surviving, it kind of works. Like, Gantz is a good example of that. Granted, Gantz is also one of those ones that had a filler ending for their TV series. But I know the manga kept going, and I've read some of that, and then I stopped at a certain point, because I... no. But there's a time where that kind of worked, and then there's... but the problem with an Everybody Dies ending is that it has a really good chance of making you not want to watch it again. And just makes it so that even the mention of the anime just fills you with depression and dread and ugh. And no anime encapsulates that better for me than Akame Ga Kill. Now, Akame Ga Kill, like, I respect it. I respect the fact that they had the balls to kill off 98% of the cast. Like, by the end, literally only two people are left alive, and they are two that clearly had the most chance of surviving, because one is the world's greatest assassin, and the other one is a world's greatest military leader who had survived near-death experiences throughout the entire thing, and never really fought on the front lines, so she could survive. But the fact that everybody else dies, and that even the main character, the guy you had been following from the very first episode, is dead before the final episode. He dies the episode before the final episode. It's so rough. And then you have, like, my favorite character, Ezra Ezdeath, who was in love with the main boy, and was on the enemy side, and watched him die. She goes crazy and wants to fight the main girl. And, you know, the main girl survives because she's the main girl and the world's greatest assassin. And it's like, ugh. It's just, it's heart-wrenching. Because, you know, you get to the point where you care about all these characters, and you like all these characters. You know what the only character I didn't care about was? The two that survived. Those two I had the least connection and the least interest in. Like, the main girl was a stone face. She didn't have strong emotions or anything that made her compelling or anything that made her interesting. The only thing that was interesting about her was her trying to save her sister, and her sister dies halfway through the show. So, it's like, so all the characters you develop emotional connections to are all murdered, and you're just kind of left with the blank slate girl. And just, it makes it, I don't even want to think about the anime anymore. I don't like talking about the anime too much, other than in this context where I'm like, this is the reason to not watch it. Like, I know there's a prequel series called Akame Ga Kill Zero. I have no desire to read that whatsoever, and I probably never will. I want nothing to do with the series ever again. Like, ugh. It's just, it's so depressing to watch. And again, it's not necessarily like it's a bad thing. I respect them for doing that. I respect them for not pulling a fairy tale and bringing everybody back from the dead by the end. Like, jeez Louise, like, Akame Ga Kill had more courage than fairy tale. Akame Ga Kill killed everybody, and fairy tale couldn't even kill the grandfather who'd been near death the entire freaking series. Like, jeez Louise. Anyway. One dishonorable mention that I will include, because I don't really count this as an ending, but it does pop up, is the cutoff ending, where it's like, they didn't end, the show just stopped. And there's a couple that do this, and a lot of times it's usually just they didn't have the funding to keep going, or they chose to do a completely different thing. It doesn't necessarily feel like an ending. Like, my favorite anime is still the original OVA for Tenchi Muyo. And Tenchi Muyo has a non-ending. It just kind of stops after, like, 12 episodes. And granted, we have gotten spin-off series since then. But even, like, the actual sequel series to the original OVA, the Tenchi Muyo Ryōoki, or whatever it's called, that one just ends with another kind of nothing ending, too. It doesn't solve anything. None of the characters grow or change. But that one at least kind of sort of felt like an ending, unlike the original. But yeah, this is usually just the show didn't get picked up or got canceled soon, or they just stopped. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's a, you hope they would get more, but I would have this with any show that just kind of ends and doesn't have actual conclusion. So, some endings, some of the worst clichés, this one that I'm going to be talking about is a very rare thing. I only can think of really two or three that it actually happened in. But this is like a combination of like two or three of the worst endings fused together. So it's a lot of the status quo returns. But it's also an everyone's dead kind of feel to it. And I call this as the universe reset ending. Now, this is an ending where, like, there's two good examples for this that I could think of. The one that I'll bring up first is Wolf's Rain. Now, Wolf's Rain was a really good, interesting kind of series, but you get to the end of it, and literally everybody dies, including the main character, and he just makes a wish or something, and they all awaken in these new bodies in a human world as normal people. And it's like, that's the end. So it's like a big reset, but a different kind of, everybody died, and then we're going to reset everyone back to the beginning. So literally you're telling me all of these characters are now separated again, trapped in a new world, have to find each other and have to try to do this mission again without everybody dying again. So literally, if you even did another show, it'd be basically the same show, except they wouldn't transform into wolves anymore. And you're like, what was the point of watching this? Like, nothing happened. Like, are you going to continue the show in this new universe? No? Then, that ending is rough. It's not the worst. The worst is Big O. Now, the Big O was a show that I tried very hard to get into. I never really fully clicked with it, but I tried my best. But it was like, you know, it had the steampunk gothic aesthetic of the Batman animated series. It had, you know, it was an interesting character, interesting kind of design. My big problem with the show had always been, like, I couldn't wrap my brain around how in the world he operated the Big O, because it had this big giant circle thing as the way to move the arms, and yet by the look of it, he should have only been able to do this, and yet it had like full range of motion and could open and close its fists and everything, and you're like, how does this little simple thing do? It was frustrating to look at it for that reason. But then you get to the finale, and the finale basically is everyone gets their mind erased. And every single character, with the exception of two side characters who are off, or the only two that remember anything happened, every single character is back to the exact same person, the exact same point, the exact same thought process that they were at the beginning of the show. And you really find, remember from the beginning of the show, they also had memory loss. So it's like, this had happened before. So how many loops down the line has this been? It's like no one ever changes or grows or becomes anything. They're basically dead. They're ghosts haunting the world, and they can never grow or change or do anything different because they cannot remember that they screwed up the first time. And humans are creatures of nature. We're gonna do the stupid thing again if we don't remember. Hey, bad things happened the last time I did that. But it is so jarring and so terrible and so frustrating to be like, so you're just telling me I just watched an entire show where nothing happened. Literally nothing that happened in the show matters at all. And that's how you end? And I get that they were hoping for a third season. This is probably not how they intended the series to end. But, jeez Louise, that's one of the worst endings I have seen of anything ever. I don't know if I could come up with a worse ending, other than maybe like the butterfly effects going back in the womb and choking yourself out as a baby thing. But, like, this is up there. This is one of the most frustrating, one of the most infuriating, confusing, hard to get, hard to understand. And I watched that episode at least two or three times because I was trying to understand it. And I, by the second or third time, I've just wanted to burn my TV and never watch anything ever again. Like, oh, it was just pure awful. And that's my list. Now I will say, I haven't seen all of the animes out there. There are probably animes with way worse endings, probably more worse cliched endings. If you have other examples of the status quo ending or the any of the these ones here or others, ending cliches that you've come across in anime that are terrible, let me know in the comments below. Do you like some of these endings? Anything of that nature, please let me know. It's been happy talking to you, happy watching, happy reading, and I will see you all next time. Bye!